Hey everybody, Reed Duke here. Welcome to a standard video here on channelfireball.com. Today I am playing Sultai Yorion, Sultai Ramp. This is a deck that I previously had called five color Sultai because I use the partially off color triomes to fuel the partially off color mythoses. For this particular iteration, I have cut Mythos of Nethroi, so we're down from five colors to four. And just generally kind of made the deck a little more interactive. I have some of these blue cards, Counterspells, Aether Gust, Thought Erasure, and then my sideboard is packing a wide variety of removal and disruption highlighted by Unmoored Ego. So I'm hoping that these cards give me an effective plan for beating that Jeskai Luka Agent of Treachery deck, in addition to just being powerful, well-rounded strategy with solid game against the aggressive decks in the format. So that's Sultai Ramp, and I'm going to play five matches on the ladder today. This is about what you sign up for with Sultai. I wish that either I had a Growth Spiral or that I was on the play. But when you have your mana in Uro and a payoff card, that's definitely good enough to be in the realm of keeping. All right, looks like I'm up against an Arclight Phoenix deck, which is one I haven't faced in a long time. Let's see what I can do. Well, what I can do so far is not very much. No turn two play here, so my opponent's going to get to do their thing, sort of goldfish for the first three or four turns. All right, that's one Phoenix. Okay, I dodged the second Phoenix, so what could have been a runaway hopefully will be a little more competitive now. Extinction Event naming even could, fortunately line up to be effective here. Not quite as good as Cry of the Carnarium, but don't worry, we'll get those after sideboarding. I guess I just really want to. I really need to hope my opponent doesn't have Aether Gust at the right time for these Cavaliers, because I need them to block. All right, there's Phoenix number two. But possibly no third spell. Okay, that's an interesting workaround. So I should probably figure my opponent has some more of that type of thing, Blitz of the Thunder Raptor. So I think that just going for the Extinction Event is going to be my safest play this turn. Those Phoenixes don't stay dead for long, but I think it's better than putting a blocker onto the battlefield that might just die immediately. Alright, so Casualties or Cavalier. We're going to start with Cavalier, especially because I am concerned about shocking myself. I think this game might come down to me stabilizing at a low life total, and I don't really want to just throw away 2 points of life if I don't have to. But I can play a super powerful spell every turn for the rest of the game, and we'll just see if it's enough. Alright. Whenever you discard one or more cards for the first time each turn, draw that many cards. So I think that's going to deserve a Casualties of War. Okay, well, rinse and repeat. This time I get to cut my opponent off of red mana. Start here. And sure, another Cavalier looks fine. Again, these are all good options that I'm choosing between. So it might seem like, hey, Reed, just do something. You're in such a good position. But, it's always worth giving that extra thought of how can my opponent come back? How do I close the door most effectively to make sure that doesn't happen? If this Yorion works, I'm going to get 7 more triggers to draw cards and put lands onto the battlefield. Do I have any worry about decking myself? I don't think so. sure, I'll just put this in play untapped, and now I have negate available. Could make a case for pretty large portion of my sideboard. Let's see, what do I not like? Nissa's pretty weak, I think. Unsure about these blue counter spells. I probably want some number of them. Also, maybe like one extinction event is enough. The cries are definitely better. And then also not sure if I want Unmoored Ego. Does seem like my opponent's deck is built pretty heavily around those Phoenixes. But Unmoored Ego is a pretty bad card, and I have the Soul Guide Lanterns already. Something like that looks pretty strong and well balanced. My opponent has mulligan to five. I did have a little bit of concern for making sure I had enough green mana since I've drawn a lot of my non-green lands, but it's definitely fine to put that forest in the graveyard. I actually think I'm just going to cycle my land this turn. Sure, so get that last blitz. It's actually a pretty decent play on my next turn is Risen Reef into Leafkin Druid. If my opponent does draw a removal spell or a counter for the Risen Reef, this card is pretty bad. It does block an Electromancer at least. I think it's fine. Now I have a powerful Yorion if I am able to untap with Risen Reef. Good way to get my life total out of danger. gonna make sure to tap my Leafkin Druid for 2 mana while the Uro's on the battlefield. First game was pretty interesting, but unfortunately it seemed like my opponent just mulliganed and didn't have much going on in the second game. Alright, that's a good way to come back. Draw 5. Sending in the Risen Reef because my opponent has to block Uro to survive. Okay, I'll see you for round 2. And I'm back. Match number 2 with Sultai Ramp. Alright, Lurrus of the Dream Den. So we got a creature deck, and I have my 2 main deck anti-creature cards in my opening hand. So definitely can't complain about that. Unfortunately, it's Lurrus and not Obosh, where Extinction Event of course, is just about perfect. Orzhov Lurrus can actually be a bit tougher for this deck because Aether Gust is not a valid defensive option. Oh, it's secret option number 3, Mardu Knights. Well, not to worry. I guess my opponent's representing Black Lance Paragon here, and I'm gonna give them credit. This time I'll block the Worthy Knight, and if they do Black Lance Paragon, I get to Extinction Event, kill everything. And if they don't, then maybe I'll play Cavalier of Thorns first. Wow, best possible turn of events. My opponent had no play, and I drew an untapped green source. I mean, presumably, they can flash in Black Lance Paragon at the end of the turn. All right. Well, all 8 board sweepers are coming in. And then I guess I have to decide about Aether Gust. I guess just something like this, one gust. Well, I feel like I definitely want to keep all my mana sources. And then note that I don't have double black yet, although Cry of the Carnarium and Extinction Event are both so good that it's hard to imagine bottoming either one. But I could regret this. I'm going to bottom Cry of the Carnarium. Because the Risen Reef is my only action card. It makes Yorion an effective play, so we'll see how this works out. Well, now I'm wishing I had that Cry of the Carnarium. All right, I'll take it. Oh no. Yeah, my decision of which card to put on the bottom has just worked out as badly as possible. Not that Cry the Cardarian would be that amazing here on turn three. I'd still leave my opponent with Knight of the Ebon Legion. But certainly would be better than what I've got now. Can Uro get me out of this? Puts me up to 6 life with 1 blocker. Still not even close. But I mean, I guess I just need to draw. Probably Cry of the Carnarium off of 1 draw step here. I'll try Uro. Okay, well, hopefully I'll just keep 7 cards and not even have to worry about that scry to the bottom decision. I'm realizing that having 4 casualties of war is surely a liability here. So, probably cut 3 for 3 gusts just because it's a card that can hypothetically defend me early. Work with this. Unfortunately, I have to choose between black mana or green mana. And I'm just going to put off that decision if I can by playing Watery Grave. Unfortunately, this could mean I don't have access to Cry on turn three. Well, take either Worthy Knight or Drill Bit. Or Black Lance Paragon. I think I'll take Drill Bit. That will give me both double black and triple green, so even though I don't really need a land, I think that's good enough. right, so the question is, am I going to block the champion into the known Black Lance Paragon? I get to put on top either Risen Reef or Cry of the Carnarium. It is only a 1-1. I'll just take it for now. It's fine. I would love to mill an Uro. That would give me something to do and a way to pull myself out of the danger zone. Powerful. All right, no blocks. Well, I could do this. This way my opponent can only save one or the other creature, either by double pumping the knight or paragoning the Fervent Champion. So it's not great, but I just need to not die somehow. And this is probably the best way of doing that. So there's my Uro. And my opponent just doesn't want to play against Uro. Okay, so far so good. I'll see you for round number three. Hey, I realized just in time that my microphone was muted, but welcome to match number three with standard Sultai ramp. My opening seven cards just had only one land, was not keepable. Then my six card hand is good. I decided to put Hydroid Krasis on the bottom because that's more of a late game card that you hope to draw into later. And I appear to be up against a Lurrus Cauldron Familiar deck. We'll see if it's Rakdos or some other color combination. Rakdos it is. I'm going to lead with Uro because that's going to guarantee 5 mana on turn 4, which is really the most important thing for stabilizing the board. Bold. Save me, Cavalier of Thorns. I think my opponent's just free rolling because they have nothing to play with Lurrus anyway. Boy, what can my opponent have? I guess they could have some double red cards. They could have Claim the Firstborn. They could have Call of the Death Dweller. Well, given that I have access to 7 mana this turn, I'd like to do, well, yeah, I'd like to do 2 things. So I think Uro and then Reef. So I'm expecting my opponent to have Claim the Firstborn, but hopefully they don't have Claim the Firstborn and a Sacrifice Outlet. Alright, I don't love taking this much damage, but I want to preserve my board so I can have a powerful Yorion turn. Well, I guess let's start here. Yeah, that killing the Risen Reef's a little bit annoying here. This would have been, of course, better with Risen Reef, but I still feel like it's pretty tough for me to lose with this wall of blockers, decent life total, and now, you know, tons of fuel for Uro Escape.
I must go.
I think with Dispute, Gust, and Negate, I can just attack with everything. The only thing I don't have is an answer to Lurrus, but shaping up, like I can certainly just overpower it, especially given that I can you know, neutralize some of my opponent's plays for next turn. Alright, just play Uro from my hand. So Dispute out, Mythos out, Nissa out, Thought Erasure, and Negate. Totally reasonable hand. Extinction Event in this matchup in particular, you know, sometimes you have to get a little lucky for it to line up well against their hand, but the fact that I could play it on turn three and either wipe up some one drops or you know, save it for the right moment, I think it's a good hand. Might be able to kill a bunch of one drops. I don't think my opponent will go for the Lurrus on turn three in a post-sideboard game like they did in game number one. But that would be amazing as one more odd casting card. Well, here we go. Wow, I'm gonna be honest with you. I didn't even know this card exiled. That's even better than I could have imagined. I thought it just destroyed even or odd creatures. I think I picked the wrong land there. I should have gone for another source of black mana in the Watery Grave. Ouch. Okay, so known act of treason. That's going to be a little bit annoying to work around. Maybe I should play this for two. Sure. All right. Yep. Saving the cry of the Carnarium for Lurrus. Sure. All right, I just need to find an action card. I have gone through a couple of Crasuses. Two Crasuses and two Cavaliers so far. But I can still find Uro, Risen Reef, two Cavaliers, two Crasus. And many of my lands have Cycling or Scry, which is good. Yeah, I think I might as well. Don't think my opponent should have conceded there, but I understand the frustration. Anyway, I'll be back for match number four. Hey, welcome back. Match number four of today's standard video. This time I'm against Yorion. So far, I've been mostly beating up on creature decks, but it's important to showcase a Yorion matchup as well. A little bit of an awkward hand. This would be totally fine, if not a great hand, if I had blue mana, but I don't, so what should I do? I know it's a Yorion deck. If I was against a Lurrus or an Obosh, I would say this hand is too slow. I have to throw it back. But I think the Yorion matchups tend to be, of such a pace that maybe I can take a few turns to wait and draw my blue mana. We'll see. I could regret this, but I'm going to keep.
Impone your prowess.
Unfortunately, I still can't double erasure next turn because these green lands don't contribute. Well, I just have to find some way, somehow, to cast Casualties of War next turn, so I guess I'm just gonna try to take away the Luka and stack an untapped land on top of my deck. Come on, one time, give me a land. If I get a tapped land, I guess I can Mythos the Fires.
Such violence is upsetting. Mind and body should move in unison, like wind and wave.
Man, I should have Mythos the Fires last turn. Because last turn I could go Mythos the Fires, cast a Thought Erasure for free, and then this turn I'd be able to Cavalier, hit a land, and casualties. But now I'm behind the curve here. I guess better late than never.
Meditate and prepare.
My opponent bricked on the Narset.
Whether whether friend or foe, state your intent. Strike with a cunning mind. If you wish to surrender now, I have just the trick for this.
Okay, so what's the plan now that I know my opponent has Luca coming next turn? Okay, say I go Nissa for free, then Mythos the Yorian for free. Blink out the fires, then I can make 6, 9, 10, 11 mana casualties, erasure, erasure.
I protect that which cannot protect itself.
Hope I have enough black mana for this. Looks like I might not. Yeah, I think I'm short one colored mana here. By the way, I didn't have to Mythos the Yorian. I could have just cast my own. I'm falling victim to the complexity of the matchup here and overlooking some important things. Well, I get full value. Artifact. Creature. Enchantment, land. Planeswalker.
This was not my plan. Rise, my elemental friend.
Yeah, that could have been played better. I wish I'd used my own Yorian instead of mythosing the opponents.
Keep an open mind. Rend the sun from the heavens. Heliod will pay. I will do my best to support you.
Wow, this is very close to lethal. Yeah. So I can only take away one of the two agents, and I would can't even survive the attack anyway. That was an interesting game. I wonder if there was a route for me to, you know, if not win, at least play a little longer. Yeah, I think the biggest error was that I should have mythosed the fires immediately. And then the next error was that I should have cast my own Yorion instead of copying the opponent's. I almost always put the Krasis on the bottom when I'm mulligan to six because I just need to develop my mana and then hope the rest falls into place from there. Looks like my opponent has also mulliganed, by the way. Sure. Bottom, bottom.
I know 88 way hone your prowess.
Well, next turn I have a lot of mana and I can do some very cool stuff.
Harder.
Okay, well, that was pretty sweet. That was my fifth turn. I guess I'm gonna ship the basic swamp. It's huge that the Risen Reef ability cuts through Narset, because otherwise Narset's a major headache for this deck with Uro and Hydroid Crisis. Yeah, like even Growth Spiral, I can't really cast into the Narset.
Meditate and prepare.
So I guess my opponent is representing Shark Typhoon and or some combination of counter spells. Okay. Seems like I want to start with Thought Erasure. So we have Shark Typhoon, Omen of the Sun, Dovin's Veto in terms of instants. It really just seems to me like I have to take the Luka. I would love to Growth Spiral into that, but remember the Narset. At least for now, I've managed to take away my opponent's combo, and we get to play a fair-ish mid-range game. Which, there's no guarantee that I'll win, but that's at least the type of game that I want to be playing. No Fires of Invention. So if my opponent at any point puts Elspeth Conqueror's Death onto the battlefield, the shields will be down, and I can copy it. Well, I'm going to try for Yorion. You can't Dovin's Veto this. And if this works, I'll get to untap with a lot of mana. I like to put the Cavalier of Thorns last because it's pretty likely you hit a scry land and then you can set up your draw step for the next turn with the maximum information. Okay, do your worst, opponent. So the best thing to have on a turn like this is Casualties of War, but the second best thing is Mythos of Aluna, and I have that. Yeah. Just conquer the conqueror. And then I guess I want to make an Uro. I don't get to draw from the Narset, but it's not like I can rattle off a million growth spirals either. Going after my Uro. So I could gust that, but I don't think I really care to do that. Just make a giant Hydroid Krasis instead. The negate feels like it should almost seal the deal.
I was not prepared for this.
Yep. Unfortunately, I can't force this past the Dovin's Veto. So I think this is a turn where I'm just making a giant, giant Hydroid Krasis. Maybe I'll start here. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 mana. I want to pass with at least 4, if not 8. I guess I'll plan with pass with 4 so I can make an 8-8 Krasis. The Thought Erasure will be real good next turn. Okay.
I have practiced against many players like you. I have just the trick for this.
Sure. The goal is just to clear the way for casualties of war. It's pricey. This is costing me 12 mana, but it's worth it. I guess actually I can probably sneak Nissa onto the battlefield while I'm at it. Alright. Jeskai Luka is defeated. Alright, one more. I'll be back. Hey, welcome back to the fifth and final match of today's standard video. I'm going for the clean sweep, 5-0 with Sultai. I'm against yet another Yorion deck, so we'll see what I can do. Good opening hand. I would swap out this Extinction Event if I could, based on knowing my opponent's companion, but the other 6 cards are great. Looks like a repeat of the previous matchup. I'm going to guess this is Jeskai Luka. Well, I guess I'll just be on the land destruction plan here. Especially since I don't have much else to cast with this turn. So, destroy the smaller Birth of Miletus and the Triome. Well, I still can't escape Uro. I could play a 5/4 or a 4/5 with no abilities, or I could just destroy another land. I think I need a little more value at the casualties, so I guess I will just play this pretty unexciting Yorion. This is where I would love to have something like Cavalier of Thorns, because that would give me additional escape fodder for Uro. Or Risen Reef would be perfect. Okay, so I'm going to guess my opponent's plan is to end of turn cycle a Shark Typhoon and then untap in Luka. So, am I going for a casualties? I think so. Why would you cycle now? Oh. Well, that changes things. I thought for sure my opponent was trying to set up Luka for next turn, but I guess given the circumstances, I'll just pass again. Nothing to get back in the graveyard. Here's my mighty play. Extinction event to kill nothing. Which gets the sixth card in the graveyard for Uro.
Cannot perceive beyond hone your prowess.
I can no longer stand by and watch. Here we go.
Might not actually work out that badly for me since I do have the Risen Reef.
a mighty warrior. I concede.
That's more like it.
Boy, I mean, I had the casualties of war this game. That part I had covered, but I wasn't able to stick anything that resulted in pressure on my opponent. And maybe I mismanaged my Yorian and my Uro. But at any rate, I need to find a way to press this advantage. Sure. So the two lands, they do produce red. They enter the battlefield tapped. Imagine I should take the Luca here. Because it's a repeatable form of Agent of Treachery. And then I can't attack into the Omen. Oh no. Oh no.
Dissenters are welcome to debate me in battle. The tools of war surround me.
Don't worry, I got this.
Can't do anything in the face of the Narset. All I can do is pass and cycle the Triome on my opponent's turn. My opponent has Mythos of Illuna, for what that's worth.
This might be a bad idea.
Doesn't seem like this is going to be enough unless I have some really strong draws.
Now what?
I wonder if somehow I should just kill the Narset there, because most of my ways to get back in this game involve Hydroid Crisis or Uro. At least I can Growth Spiral on my opponent's turn now and get a little bit more traction.
I only bond with the strongest around me.
The tragedy of my death has only strengthened my resolve. Believe in yourself as I believe in you.
Negate doesn't do enough. Okay, I can work with this. My opponent is mulligan to 5. I'm going to wait on my Leafkin Druid, try to get extra value out of the Risen Reef. Though, maybe I should just try to get Nissa in play as quickly as possible. But I think this will be fine as well. Plus, 50% of the time I hit a land and have the turn 4 Nissa anyway. Alright, well, that one was not very competitive, but we do find ourselves match 5, game number 3, playing for the 5-0. This is as tense as it gets here on channelfireball.com. can work with this. Aether Gust is a little bit narrow, but it is effective at stopping Fire's Invention in Luca. Well, I think I'm just going to pass with Mystical Dispute, because I really don't want Teferi or Narset to hit the battlefield this turn. Huh. Is it time for that? Yeah, I think I should probably just resolve it when I can. Agent of Treachery. Okay, so my opponent has a pretty good, you know, blue-white control type hand. Is there anything else Luca can hit? Alright, so Luca's gonna pretty much do nothing. I mean, it can deal some damage to me, I guess, but one less thing to worry about. Two less things to worry about, in fact. Sure. Draw a card, you know, gets around Elspeth Conqueror's Death. Not too bad. So this just has to be representing Mystical Dispute, right? I just don't think there's anything else it could possibly be. No triple green for the Cavalier. Okay, I still get my card. So now I have the Mythos to answer Elspeth Conqueror's Death at any point. I just have to manage, you know, somewhat carefully around Shatter the Sky, and I think I'll be okay. In some ways, this is playing into Shatter the Sky, but in other ways, it's getting maximum value out of my cards. The Leafkin Druids are, you know, if I can get a card's worth of value out of these before they die to Shatter the Sky, then that's a win. That's a good use of the Druid. Sure. It's actually pretty annoying.
I have just the trick for this.
Yeah, I guess it was a little wasteful to play the Scryland when I knew the Cavalier was coming back.
Meditate and prepare.
Can't force through the mythos.
I was not prepared for this.
I think this is probably a fine use of Mystical Dispute. It's going to be hard to find a time to resolve it other than this. With no Agent of Treacheries in the deck, there's not, you know, not a blue card that's costing my opponent six or more mana. Okay, so now presumably my opponent will target my Uro and I can gust it in response. I think that's worthwhile. All right. I have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 mana. I think I want to just do Erasure and Mythos. Although I could do Uro and Mythos. No, Erasure first. The game remains close because my opponent's going to get something back from the graveyard before my Elspeth Conqueror's Death goes off, so they can get, for example, Teferi and then bounce my token. Interesting. That is interesting. Yeah, I guess I'll name Teferi Time Raveler. So I do get it out of the graveyard.
This is hardly.
So now they'll get back, I guess, you know, Narset or Yorion. But then I'll get my Elspeth Conqueror's Death, and that can return Nissa or Risen Reef. Nissa.
Witness the ties that bind us all.
Wow, that was good. One top, one bottom. So my opponent must have something that they think will help them in their path to winning this game.
Behold, nature's true power.
This game was just all unmoored ego. You know, if this Luca, instead of being a dead card in hand, had been stealing my best stuff starting on turn 5, this game would have been a nightmare. But unmoored ego really evened the playing field. So I guess my opponent could have Shark Typhoon here, which would make a 6-6. Just gonna take my card drawing while I can. So I guess if my opponent finds something along the lines of Shatter the Sky, they can attack Nissa, kill Nissa with the Omen, but looks like they didn't find it. All right, that was hard fought, but I did get the 5-0 with Sultai Ramp. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you'll give the deck a try. And remember, if you ever want to see more content in Standard or any other Magic format, you can find it on channelfireball.com or by subscribing to the YouTube channel. Hope to see you next time.